This is the backside of a solar panel, 160 watt piece, which had a problem. The diodes, which are here in the box, were burned and made short circuit, so the panel didn't work because all the current produced by the panel was flowing through the diodes. So now I want to fix it and put new ones. It would also work without them, but it's good to have them in case you connect multiple panels in series. So I am going to open this. So this is how it looks from the inside, and the backside of the cover has these two spots which are clearly somehow melted from the heat from the diodes. And now I'm going to search two replacement diodes on my heat gun. Okay, here I have the two diodes which I am going to use to replace. You can look at the number and search it on the data sheet on Google. I think it's capable of handling 12 amps, but this panel only delivers 8 or something like this. It's a good thing to do just to check the diodes in case they came broken, if the voltage drop is 0.7 or whatever. Wrong priority. Point 176. Wow, this is very small. 0.181. Very nice. I laid the panel on the floor so I don't have to hold with one hand the diodes and with the other hand the heat gun and with another hand the camera and so on. So I have more hands to do. I've set the heat gun at 260 degrees Celsius. I don't know if this is enough, too much, too little. I am still learning to use this machine. So I've done this off camera because I don't have that many hands to hold different stuff. I'm not very proud of, but I think it will work. Now the next thing is place the cover, put it in the sun and measure if everything is okay. So this panel should produce in open circuit about 20 to 23 volts. This is 21.8, so I think this is fine. And now I will also check the short circuit current. Okay, now I will check the short circuit current. It is okay, about 8 amps. So I think this little panel can be declared as repaired.